Cuddle up, truth seekers. Uncle Mikey has another bedtime story. Back to Mike Malloy.
Twenty-five before the hour, and let me share with you our sponsors for this hour once again. First, Paul Karsh. Paul writes, "We true seekers know that Lion Ryan and Full of Admit just pull stuff out of Carl Rove's butt. But when you talk about this with your gullible friends and neighbors, wouldn't it be nice to know precisely what those lies are and what the truth is? Now, it's easy. Just go to tinyurl.com/Romney's Lies to see a description of some of their lies and links that that document the truth. We don't get all of them. After all, there aren't enough hours in the day for that. But we do get a few of the big ones that they keep repeating, even after they've been exposed as blatant falsehoods. Again, that URL is tinyurl.com/Romney's, no apostrophe, Romney's Lies. In the face of the Republican lie machine, let's take a stand for truth and justice. Once again, that's tinyurl.com/Romney's Lies. Good one, Paul. Also from Gary and Judy Niss, retirees in Portland, Oregon, who write, "Mike, keep spreading the truth. Unions are not bad. Collective bargaining is a rational process between humans. Pensions and retirements are not bad words. Our American government should not be privatized. Privatization means success for a few and failure for the area being served. Voter suppression and faulty voting machines and procedures throughout the country threaten the democratic process. Check out Romney Family and Voting Machines at truthout.org. Remind people of who the Koch brothers are, using billions of dollars to trample the working class and manipulate the democratic process. Expose these evil actors for the vermin they are. Thanks again, Mike, for all you do. Much appreciated." And finally, this hour, Paul, who is Sean H. in the chat room, would like to thank Congressman Paul Ryan of Wisconsin for reminding him not to lie about his ultramarathon times, and congratulate Kay Petrini for her epic run in the October 14th Nike Marathon. Kay placed 3,038th overall, 182nd in her division, and ran 26.2 miles in 5 hours, 31 minutes, and 5 seconds. Now that's guts. Kudos to Kay. Good job out there. Oh, and rot in hell, Paul Ryan, wherever you are. Thanks, Paul. I didn't know Kay's time was... How do you run for 5 hours? Holy Toledo. I would not... the days... of running competitively for me, well, they never were, but I mean, if they did exist, they are long gone. The U.S. Supreme Court today rejected an attempt by the Christian crazies in Oklahoma, the anti-abortion activists in Oklahoma, to place what anti-woman privacy nutcases, what they call a personhood amendment, on the Oklahoma ballot to define an embryo as a human being from the moment of conception. The anti-women's privacy group Personhood Oklahoma had appealed to the Supreme Court after the Oklahoma Supreme Court struck down that ballot initiative back in April. Now, the ballot in question would have asked Oklahoma voters to amend the state constitution to expand the definition of a human being to include a fertilized egg. Did it say human egg or a fertilized egg? The state's highest court said that that constitutional amendment was, quote, clearly unconstitutional because the U.S. Supreme Court already had decided the issue. Now, passage of that law or a constitutional amendment would have the effect of banning abortion, period, in the state of Oklahoma. The Center for Reproductive Rights, the American Civil Liberties Union, and local women's privacy rights groups sued back in March to keep the proposed initiative off the November election ballot. On appeal to the country's highest court, Personhood, Oklahoma, argued that the state court's decision to block the initiative took away our rights of free speech and to participate in a democratic process. Eggs, yes. Born children, no. Eggs, yes. Born children, no. But the U.S. Supreme Court, without comment, refused to hear the case, according to the order issued today. Groups that try to protect women's right to privacy welcomed the court's decision. Nancy Northrup, president of the Center for Reproductive Rights, said in a statement, quote, pure and simple, these tactics are an affront to our nation's constitution and a bald-faced attempt to foreclose a woman's access to a full range of reproductive health care, end quote. Now, Keith Mason, who's the president of Personhood USA, eggs, yes, children born, no, eggs, yes, said his group and its local affiliates would go on trying in Oklahoma and other states to pass such a law through the legislature or the ballot box. Now, similar initiatives were tried in Colorado and Mississippi, but in both instances, those amendments were defeated. Fertilized eggs would be a human being and get the full force and attention and protection of these sick sons of bitches on the political right. But children who are living in poverty, children who, if they are lucky enough to have two parents living with them, have parents who don't work, can't find a job. What the hell do you do in Oklahoma? No offense, Oklahoma, but, you know, what the hell do you do in Georgia? Well, Georgia has Atlanta. So fertilized eggs, you see, and it has nothing to do with that. That's the false front. That's what they put out there. Personhood, USA, we believe in personshoods and stuff. No, you don't, you lying, duplicitous, sneaky, slimy, right-wing Christian bastards. No, you don't. What you believe in is denying a woman's right to privacy. You can't stand that because a woman might go off and do things. So why don't you cut the crap, you freaky right-wing Christian bastards? Why don't you cut the crap? Why don't you just come out and say that you belong to an organization and you have your brothers in the Protestant and Catholic and Muslim and Orthodox Jewish movements? You're all Abrahamic freaks. You all have decided that a woman's place is under your boot. And the idea of her having reproductive freedom and privacy just scares the living crap out of you. Why don't you just come out and say it? Instead of running around with your hair on fire talking about fertilized eggs or persons. Goddamn freaks. At bradblog.com. Oh, by the way, Brad Friedman's going to fill in for me tomorrow night. We have an event to attend at Molly's school, which we will be attending. And Brad Friedman has graciously agreed to fill in for us tomorrow night. So he will be here. We'll be back Wednesday. But from his blog, the National Weather Service has been telling us over the past several days that the serious impact of the superstorm called Hurricane Sandy is not to be underestimated. But there's another concern that has been keeping me awake over the past week or so. NBC's Al Roker spelled out that concern briefly on Sunday's Meet the Press, explaining what I've been worried about since it became clear that the storm could have serious ramifications on Election Day. I'm not talking about the political ramifications, about its effect on planned campaign events between now and Election Day, on early voting turnout, or even how it's handled by Obama and FEMA, etc. I'm talking about the serious question of whether voters will be able to vote on Election Day at all, particularly in states which force voters to use electronic voting systems at the precincts. Roker told NBC's David Gregory, before Gregory hurried to ignore the comment entirely, Roker said, quote, "We expect massive power outages throughout the area. As the system moves onshore, it's going to be a long-term effect. It's going to last for about 72 hours, and so we're talking about people could be without power for at least 10 days. That, as you know, will take it right into Election Day. So what will people do if they can't get to the voting booth or the voting booth doesn't have power?" End quote, Al Roker. Good question, Al, one we've warned about here for a number of years. There are about half a dozen states, and they're listed at Brad's website, directly in harm's way where voters are forced to use 100% unverifiable electronic voting systems on Election Day. In those locations, unless they have enough emergency paper ballots printed up to accommodate the entire electorate at precincts where power remains disrupted, there could be very serious and unprecedented problems. No kidding.